Hello guys, I told you I'd meet you back here, and I did. See, I didn't lie. Anyways, this will be an actual episode featuring pretty big lady Chou-Chou. Although she's not really big, she's just really close to the camera. Oh my god, I can't fix it. Okay, there we go. Now, you may see on the mini-map those little ghosts with black eyes. This shows me where enemies are. Although, I can't say it's completely right, because there's two enemies here. Oh yeah! Did I get them? Encounter attack. Okay, yes, I did. Oh, good. Hey, you're from Hyperdimension Neptunia. I'll kill you first. Mr. Tulip. Vable. Whoa! Triple counter stop! I'm pretty sure you get a trophy for that, actually. Okay. Hit. Smile. Confession. Okay, that didn't work. That didn't work. That didn't work. Damn it! Can I do it again? I cannot. Die, Hornet! I'm not really good at melee kills. They're kind of confusing. Actually, no, they are confusing. They're really confusing to me. I don't understand them. Hoya! Oh, you're not an enemy? Oh, man. Well, then I guess the mini-map is correct. Oh, man, there was something I wanted to talk about, but I forgot. And I feel like it was oh, damn. I feel like it was actually a bit important. My turn. Simple status. Okay, effects normal. Oh, I'm trying to press triangle to advance. Smile, glare, confession. Come on, please work. Oh, no. Okay, fine. Jeez. Card gain. Ow. Oh my gosh. Ah, no skills. Oh well. Actually, I should probably check if Teto has any. Or if I have any. For Teto. Could it be that the English peons don't have voices? That's why they don't... Aw, oh, come on! I don't have anything. Witch evade. Activating magic attacks are evaded. Oh, hey, this is like in a garrison war. My, I hope everybody doesn't have that. Well, I hope enemies don't. I should be limited to only me. And me only. Oh my gosh. No, 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 no. Dude, that... Okay, that bee... That better not be the bee. Okay, it's not. But man, that thing moves fast! Hello, explanatory Shampooru here again. Have you gotten used to the battle system? Offering skills and specials today. Both can be selected via the skill command. Skills require SP to use, whereas specials require SP and PP. Oh, PP stands for peon points, and they can be obtained by turning foes into peons or items. Skills and specials are more powerful than normal attacks, and some can even strike multiple opponents at once. Blink, blink. What's more, each character has certain techniques they excel at, so please confirm those on the status screen. Use these effectively to defeat your enemy.
Watch me, Lady Chou-Chou.
Well, let's see what Ryu Token do. Whoa, what the heck? Okay, let's do Fighting Spirit on Berkshire here. Wow, dang. Just like hit him really hard one time. Next up is an advanced fighting mechanic. It's called the Blast Off System. As it sounds, the Blast Off System is used to knock enemies into other foes, allies, or the battle map's borders. Using the Blast Off System has several benefits. First, knocking enemies together will deal extra damage. Knocking foes into allies, crystals, or walls will also result in extra damage, trying to knock them all over the place. Second, someone hit by an enemy who has been blasted off may have their turn delayed. third, your resulting G and Mugen points will increase based on the hit count from a successful blast-off. One hit is added each time the enemy collides with another enemy, an ally, or a crystal. Here's how you perform a blast-off attack. By that, right there. Go to the skill menu. When you have the cursor on the technique, you will use toggle blast off with the squares button. When toggled on, blast off will go into effect wherever the skill is used. Oh, this doesn't matter yet. Keep in mind that I'll explain the blast off power meter inside the red frame later. Okay. Alright, I've been talking for a while, so let's give it a try now. Oh, they don't let me melee kill. Fine. Two-part cut. Huh. Okay, hold on. I'll just attack one of them back there. Good. I'll continue. When the screen gets like this, choose the direction and distance for your blast-off attack. Direction first. If you're in the yellow part, use the directional buttons or the left stick to shift the hit's direction, distance. This depends on the blast-off power meter. Use the L1 and R1 buttons to adjust this meter. It's pretty obvious, but the higher the blast-off meter value, the farther the distance the enemy will travel. The field effect created by the large crystal can also alter the difference on an distance an enemy will travel. Blink, blink. That's right there. The slippery field effect, for one, will increase the travel distance. A sticky field effect has the opposite effect. Oh my gosh. After choosing a direction and distance, press the convert button, and blast off will commence. Okay, so I think... I want to say yes. Let's max it out. Oh, they have a button for that. Okay, confirm. Boom, boom. Oh my gosh. Oh no, I killed Ryuto. I'm so sorry, I didn't mean to kill you. Oh, what an overwhelming blast off. With that, the blast-off power meter will decrease by the amount chosen. Using skills can restore the depleted meter. Oh, well, I probably shouldn't have done that then. Look at the blast-off value in the red frame to see how much it will replenish. Use the blast-off option effectively to keep the tide of battle in your favor. Aww. Fresh out of the battle, I got back attacked. What happened? Ha! Jerk. Abuse, crybaby, kind, I guess? Hands and knees, become my chair. Oh my gosh. Seems all I can do is make the freaking crystal go into a frenzy. Linkage. Spinning top. This is new. Final strike. Skill. No skills. Oh. Tank! Oh my gosh, they actually have tanks. Oh my god! Okay, nothing special there. But oh man, I freaking destroyed Ryuto, I'm so sorry. Okay, here we... Wait, what? Ryuto. Oh, come in. Okay, I don't know why they won't let me bring him back to life. Oh, hey. Flimsy spear, shackle, Nahouse. Ugh, if someone knows how to say that, or there's like an agreed universal way to say it, please let me know, because I don't know it.
We won't find either of them so easy. We have to carefully search the entire world.
Well, he looks like a hero. Crash, shatter. What the heck is he doing?
Jeez. Throwing vases around without saying a single word.
Is he looking for rupees? Or whatever the currency is here.
Oh, look at it! He waltzed into someone else's home. I don't think he got permission to look in there. He's not just a dangerous man. He's a crook, a criminal.
Well,
crime. I guess panty thieves do exist. I'm all for acts of evil, but he seemed kind of icky.
What's he trying to say?
Vase fragments all over the place. That's really dangerous. What if someone steps on them? Don't forget, the people living in the home let him do it. They probably think he's too dangerous.
That is a hero.
Wanna repeat that?
He's a hero. Probably.
Probably.
You're a real comedian, aren't you? Didn't you just say that heroes are cool and everyone looks up to them?
That's still the truth. I wouldn't lie to you. If a hero sees a clay pot or vase, he's inclined to break it. If he sees a drift, he's compelled to open it.
That's crazy. What kind of mental affliction is that? Now, at least we found one of the people we were looking for.
Yeah, you don't know what you'll find in a clay pot.
Sicko, my peon gives me goosebumps. Don't be like that. I know how you feel, but remember, it's for the sake of universal domination.
And we're back to the happy music.
There he is, the hero from before. Something still makes me feel unwashed and greasy about this.
No, unwashed and greasy.
Suck it up and turn him into your adoring little underling.
Wait, someone else is with him.
Oh, you're right. You're crapping me. My heart. I'm really embarrassed.
Sandy, how many times must I remind you? It's not Sir Skyheart, but Lord Hero.
I apologize.
Parameters are uncharacteristically high. Is there a problem?
Yes, I just said it was a problem. Please allow me. We are ordinary.
That's great.
Hero.
Request denied. Only the hero has the right to decide what his fellow party members may equip.
I'm not another party member. Please let me return to my castle.
Wow.
A bikini! My holy god!
You perform the trick here. You're pathetic. Okay, enough of this. Hey, you!
Huh? Who are you?
Who am I? What do you think you are? Parading a poor girl around in a tiny bikini.
Oh, dear.
look at me.
I only do what is proper for a hero.
Proper my ass.
Ah, I know your type. You're upset that I haven't allowed you to wear a bikini too.
Huh?
A moment. I've many other swimsuits. Let me see if one of these will fit your petite frame.
I don't need a stinking bikini. Why should I wear one anyway?
Well, if that's not it, then I don't have any more words to waste on you. Scram.
I still got something to say!
Wow.
Wow, I've never seen our dear little Chou-Chou get snapped like that.
He's definitely a hero. A cut above the rest.
Oh man, this guy's pissed me off. I'm gonna pee on his ass right now!
Pee on his ass? Really, is that really the right approach?
Did you just do something?
Ineffective? So, I don't get you going or something?
Get me going? I've no idea what you're babbling about. I'll waste no more time on you. Let's march, Sandy.
Oh, please save me!
Go, spell that magically returns me safely to the castle.
How convenient.
Wait, no fair! I picked him as just another pervert, but he seems to be a bona fide hero. Chou-Chou's charms actually failed, too. That was just a fluke. No matter what, he'll be all mine.
Well, that was funny. I haven't played it. Well, actually, I may have, but it just seems so. It seems to make so much sense. Like, bikinis have great stats. But I never stopped to think about how my party members actually felt about wearing them. Oh well, they have uncharacteristically high defense stats. Oh, cool. My gosh, I wish there was... Oh! Look at that. There is a way to center the camera. You just push down on R3. That is so good. I'm going to use that forever now. Here's another event point.
Okay, settle down and be my peon.
Wait, didn't he teleport to the castle? Oh, it's an enemy. He seems confused.
It ran away.
Another fluke.
Nice emotion.
Why? You failed here and with that hero. Maybe your ability isn't omnipotent. That's a big fat lie. I'm just feeling a little clammy. This is no good. We've already hit a yellow light in our travel plans. If we fail, then I've also... Okay, in this situation, we'll ask someone who you made into your peon directly.
Someone who was made into a peon? So, me?
Duh. How did it feel to become her peon? Did it hurt or make you cry?
Hurt.
She was so darn cute, and my heart was instantly hers, so... Hey, what are you making me say?
Then you became hers because you fell head over heels for her? Or did you become a peon first and love her after?
This is way too embarrassing!
Please answer. It's very important.
The first time I laid my eyes on her, I thought, wow, what a cutie! And then I became her loyal underling.
Well, that was easy.
So, if this means that, then that must mean this. Chou-Chou... It's just a theory, but... Huh? Spill, I believe your ability to gain peons is only effective against those who find you attractive. Huh? What? What's more, it appears the only people who like you are of a similar age and have underdeveloped tastes in girls. That's not true at all! Over 90% of the people in the universe think I'm cute. Don't turn a blind eye to reality. But if that's really the case, then our plan has failed. My domination scheme!
It's indisputable that Lady Shushu is a total hottie. But different strokes for different folks. I mean,
different strokes for different folks.
It's dumb and annoying to admit, but if that's the case, I just gotta make everyone think I'm cute, right? Yes, but there are limits. No matter how you dress or make yourself up, you're still you. Your tiny boobs, for one. If that's all there is, I'll just do this.
Huh? Well, Lady Shushu, what are you?
Huh?
This part's fun.
What? At least they're bigger than yours now, dear Andres.
That reaction.
Don't ask, don't tell, darling.
CC sadist.
See? Now even the fools who like big cans won't be able to resist me.
Wait! How can you act like that was normal?
So, in other words, basically, you can change your physical form? What? You mean you guys can't?
There's no way.
What the
we
hell?
Could.
So that's expected.
What kind of creature can change its whole body? What? I don't know what you're saying, but I think I understand. You're so weak, you only have like 3 forms, right?
I can barely maintain one.
Well, us normal people. Never mind, I'm not really.
Yeah, me too.
That, but I can't change forms. Really? Being human sucks.
But she's not human. Ryuto, maybe.
Normal people can't live up to what this girl's notion of what normal is. You mentioned 3 forms for weaker individuals. So does that mean you have more than that tucked away? Naturally, I'm the undisputed god of the universe. My power eclipses the common people a zillionfold. I count 1, 2, 3, 7! 7 different forms!
1, 2, 3, 7!
Double a weakened power.
Every double spells twice the trouble, so they say.
And 7, just like the amount of worlds.
I just remembered I
How convenient.
Well, I'll bring them all out now.
Whee! Whee! Oh, the noir form.
This form's perfect for running around and being crazy energetic. I have neglected showing you this form, had I not? It is a pleasure to make your acquaintance at last.
Oh, she's so beautiful.
When I'm like this.
Prudurut form. Oh, I like terse. Enough said. Next form.
That's it. How'd you like my show?
Those were all you?
Believe they were the same girl. Bet that one of these forms will get the hero sword a swinging.
Wow. Get his sword a swinging. Wow, that's disturbing. I'm not gonna think about that. Oh, now it's burned into my head. Oh my god. And his sword is swinging, really? Come on. Ah. Another new game feature. This is Lady Shushu's exclusive ability, Form Change. I see, we were real creatives with the game terminology. Oh, I read that wrong. Hold on, rewind. I see we were real creative with the game terminology. Wow, I still messed up. Dang. Shut up. You got a problem with it? No, not at all. Just trolling. On the field, Lady Shushu's form can be changed by pressing the L1 button. If you plan ahead and shape your form based on the enemy's moe and move preferences, moe kills will go smoothly. Form change can also be performed mid-battle. Press the L1 button during Lady Shushu's turn or choose form change from the command list. Form change can only be used once before your turn. The number of times you can change per battle is limited too. You can reset the counter by returning to G-Castle instead of using it recklessly. Use it strategically. I should also take this opportunity to explain charm level. Huh? There's more of this junk? Please don't say it like that. This is an important gameplay mechanic. Charm levels are precisely that, a numeric value of Lady Shushu's charms. This value will increase as you gather more and more Shampoo-Roos. Increasing your charm level will let you access stronger moe kills and will raise the times you may form change in battle. Get into the pattern of collecting Shampoo-Roos and raising your charm level. This makes it easier to get more out of us. Please gather many Shampoo-Roos and raise your charm level. Raise your charm level, Lady Shushu. Oof. Why is it so hard to read? How do I English? Oh, this looks suspicious. Anyways, we're running low on time, so I am going to grab these items. Junk sword. Darkness in the house. Oh, how convenient. I may as well do one more fight, huh? No, come here. Ah! Dude! He, like, totally owned slash faked me out. Okay, hyper sadist. Okay, a confession. I don't know, I'm desperate here. Oh my gosh, it's so hard. So hard to get moe kills. What does this look like? Nothing special, just beating the mess out of him. Tank. We've already seen Tank. Triple barrel. Bang, bang, bang. Oh man. That was point blank too? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, I forgot about Ryuto! Oh. I need to do something. They won't let me revive him. Revive slash restores HP. Look, it's just sugar. Why? Why? Ugh, whatever. I'm just gonna run back to the G-ship. Well, with that said, I'll meet you guys back at this crystal over here. Because I have to go to the G-ship and revive Ryuto. Dang it. Oh well. I'll see you guys next time. Thank you for watching. And I hope you're enjoying this series. So far, it's been pretty funny. Can't wait to see the rest of the game. Well, bye-bye.